In this video, I'll explain how to add a screen share overlay to your scene in Ecamm Live. Back to the main scene, so we've just created our web widget overlay within our second scene, and now I'll create a new scene by clicking the plus button here. And I'm going to call this Keynote, because I have a Keynote presentation running. So again, a simple way of adding Keynote presentation to your live stream production using the screen share overlay. So we've got a scene called Keynote. I'll again add a camera overlay because I prefer to have the person who's speaking with the presentation present actually on the scene. It's personal preference. You don't have to do this, but I thought I would add the camera overlay anyway. If you notice, it's remembered the exact settings that we had during the last scene that we created. So I asked for a circle camera overlay and I just added one down here, and Ecamm remembers the last setting you had, which is super convenient. So now we want to add our Keynote presentation. So just to make you aware of how I've got mine set up, I have a second monitor connected to this Mac, and that second monitor is currently running a Keynote presentation. It's not in full screen. It's in the dock mode, which means it's just playing within a window, and you can set Keynote up to do that. So it's in a sort of a resizable window, which is great, but it doesn't matter. You could have it full screen and share the entire screen, and I'll show you how to do that right now. So let's go back to our Keynote scene and let's add this overlay down here, which is the screen share overlay. It's just the icon of a little computer, click on that. And by default, it's going to share the primary display, in which case it's my laptop display. And you'll notice that even though you're seeing the Ecamm panels and controls, the screen share isn't going to show anything related to Ecamm, which is great. You can do that, but by default, it's not going to show you anything related to Ecamm. So it's not going to show you Ecamm running in the background or anything like that, which is great because you could have some graphics or a presentation behind Ecamm and you can just share that. But for the purposes of this demo, I've got a secondary monitor and that's what I'm going to share a portion of. So you can see here that this is just the main laptop screen. And we know that by, if you go to the little pen tool and click on that, you'll see that it's actually showing the primary display. And the shape of this window is the same aspect ratio as my laptop screen. But I don't want to show the primary display. I've got a couple of options when I click on this drop-down menu. I can share the entire secondary display that I've got connected to my laptop. I can share the current application that's running, which would be Keynote. Or I can pick any one of these that's running currently on my machine. So let's go and share the secondary display and show you what that looks like. So sharing the secondary display, let me make that a little bit bigger. You can see that it's sharing everything on my screen. If I make it the same aspect ratio as the secondary display, which is here, because my secondary display is slightly different size than my laptop, you can see now that I'm actually sharing, I just get rid of those controls, I'm sharing the entire screen. So you can see the Keynote controls here. You can see the clock and everything that it will be displayed with the full display. But I might not want to share that. I'm just interested in sharing the Keynote display itself. So you can do a couple of things. This is a screen share of the entire display. And if you wanted to clean this up, you could hit the Option key as you click on the side. As you can see here, it actually changes. We just get rid of those controls. So when you hit the Option key, you get this little arrow, double-sided arrow, and this means that you can just crop in to the part of the image that you want to see. So you can remove all this superfluous menu and everything else. And now I'm just cropping in and cleaning up what I'm showing. And now you can move this around, make it full size, like that. You'd have a nice background maybe. You can center it so it's perfectly centered like you would do normally, snaps into place, and then I will move the screen share, because it's a layer, down below the camera. Bit of housekeeping, double click on the name of the screen share, and I'll call it Keynote. And now we can actually see what it is. So that's my Keynote presentation. If I go over to my other screen, I can then start to cycle through my presentation as I would do normally. So it's a great, easy way of sharing your Keynote presentation, especially if you're using a secondary monitor. Now, if you're not using a secondary monitor, you can still share your Keynote, but you can share it in a different way. So let's move back. Let's just get this back to the main screen, bring this over here. So instead of sharing a portion of the screen, let's just cancel out of that a second. Let's delete this overlay that we've just created. Let's add the screen share overlay again. Again, we don't want the primary display, we want the secondary one. But now I actually want to share the Keynote application. So if I click on the Keynote application, that now is just going to show me the Keynote presentation window that I've got open. As you can see, it's not showing any of the controls, any of the desktop itself. It's just showing me the Keynote presentation. And again, if I hit the option to clean it up, I'll just option, click and drag, clean up the presentation like this. So it gets rid of anything else. And then I can resize, go back to my overlays menu, drag the screen share below the camera. So I'm sitting on top. And I go back to my other monitor and I'm controlling Keynote again. So as you can see, it's number of different ways of sharing the same type of overlays within Ecamm, but it makes it very easy and very flexible to share whatever you want. So there's two prime examples of how you can actually share part of your desktop, part of your screen, a web widget, and things like that. And if you check out the forums and the Ecamm help pages, it will take you through all the different types of overlays that you can add to your Ecamm Live presentation. I just wanted to share with you a couple of examples to make it easy for you to share your screen, your presentation, or a web widget. There are a number of amazing resources available to help you get started with Ecamm Live, enabling you to stream like a boss. And I've listed a number of the key resources here to help you with your Ecamm journey. And I'd encourage you to join the Discord or the Facebook group, as there are a bunch of knowledgeable people waiting to help and support you on these platforms. Take it easy, happy streaming, and welcome to the Ecamm fam.